our pledge.
Good evening and welcome to East Jackson High School. We're going to be hosting the board member tonight. Cadet Private First Class Chemistry Grace is a first-year student who has excelled in the ROTC classroom. In her short time in the program, she has led 10 flagging tails and completed 5 color marks. She's also excelled in the classroom by earning a first semester grade of A. She's an outstanding student, and we're honored to have her in our ROTC program, and she will be leading the pledge to flag tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in reciting the pledge of allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, for liberty and justice for all.
At this time, we need to approve our minutes. Hope everybody's had a chance to look over those. Do I have a motion that we approve the minutes from our last meeting?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, you're good. And the approval of the agenda, do we need to make any corrections or changes?
I'd just like the board's support in flipping, I'd like to ask the board's support in changing to flipping 2 and 3. We're going to go down to the front so that we can see the highlights of East Jackson High School's presentation. And while we're down there, that will allow us to move forward with our Teachers of the Year, but come back up for our Rotary students as well as the remainder of the agenda.
Okay, with those changes, do I have a motion that we accept our agenda for tonight?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
Okay, all in favor? All right, very good. Okay, we will turn it over now to Ms. Jackson for the highlights.
All right, Ms. Palmer, I'll turn the mic over to you and you'll take the board on down front so that they can see all the activities that you have planned. Thank you for hosting us.
So as the board is making their way to their seats, what we decided to do is highlight our fine arts department for our instructional moment this evening. Number one, because I think they're absolutely phenomenal. You'd be hard-pressed to find another fine arts department that was this fabulous anywhere in. But secondly, we thought that this might bring a little bit of entertainment value to you folks and this Monday evening as well. So when you entered, I hope that you noticed our art displays in the lobby. Ms. Tamara Manchester, who is here in the front, is our art instructor. And she teaches visual arts 1 and 2, pottery 1, 2, and 3, drawing, painting 1, 2, and 3, and photography 1 and 2. Again, if you didn't check out the artwork when you came in, please do so. Enjoy reading. She has over 200 students in her art program, so we're excited about the growth in that program. And then as you were coming in, you should have also heard our jazz band play. And the East Jackson Band Program has experienced continued growth over the last several years. This year alone, the band program has over 200 students. Playing in various bands. The band has had a record number of students audition to make district honor band, and just recently, over the last 2 weeks, they have had 4 students selected in the Georgia All-State Band. This year, the band program was selected to play at the Georgia School Board Conference. They achieved their highest marching band competition scores in school history, and our band has received an invitation to perform in Normandy, France in the year 2020, so we're pretty excited about that too. And so now I believe some of our chorus kiddos are going to perform a number, and as they're coming out, yes, come on out, I'll say a little bit about you guys. East Jackson Chorus, under the direction of Dr. Todd Chandler, has grown from only 51 students in the year 2016 to 198 students currently, so huge growth in this program, and I think you'll see why in just a moment. The EJCHS courses consistently score high ratings in LGPE, which is the Large Group Performance Evaluation. They place in the top tier at GHSA competitions and continue to be ambassadors for the Jackson County School System. Last semester, they were the only high school involved or invited to perform during the Pearl Harbor Day concert series in Oahu, Hawaii. where they performed at the historic site of the USS Arizona and on the fan scale of the USS Missouri. They are currently preparing audition materials to perform at one of the most revered national monuments, the National Cathedral in Washington, D.C. Mr. Chandler, it is yours.
He was a famous trumpet man from out Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man of his craft. And then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand, because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B.
A toot,
a toot,
a toot, did a lot of toot.
He blows an A to the bar. In boogie rhythm, he can't play a note unless a bass and guitar is playing rhythm. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. He is some boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he plays boogie-woogie bugle, he is busy as a buzzy bee. And when he plays, he makes the company jump and A to the bar. He is a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B.
That is one of the members of the Board of Choir. And it's there, Lily. I'll tell you a little bit about our next performers. This evening are our dance students. We are in EJCHS High School. We have a dance program which teaches modern dance, ballet, hip hop, point, and tap. Currently, Ms. Loggins has over 200 students in her dance program. Tonight, we'd like to showcase a piece of student choreography from our tap class. Our
tap classes are fun, upbeat, and entertaining to watch. Colin Chandler, Lauren Thomas, and Anna Talbert, who are all seniors, they've been dancing their entire time here at East Jackson. It's been exciting to see them progress over the years. And tonight we're going to go back to December, bring back a little bit of the holidays, and they're going to be performing a piece from our December recital to the music Up on the Housetop.
Up on the housetop, up on the housetop, up on the housetop. For the little ones, Christmas joys. Oh, oh, oh.
Click, click, down through the chimney with your sing.
Up on the housetop.
in the spring when they do their spring recital. If for no other reason than to see Kelly try to get 200 kids on the stage for the grand finale at the end. It's pretty entertaining. And then our final performance, and you may recognize her from the chorus group, this is Abigail Suarez. She's one of our GHP candidates in drama this year. She feels just as comfortable on stage playing a character as she does in the tech booth, working lights or sound, which is normally where you'll find her. This year, she was voted to be in the All-Star cast at the Region 1 Act competition, and she won first place last year in the Region Literary Competition when she performed several different roles in a 10-minute presentation of To Kill a Mockingbird. Tonight, she's going to be performing a selection from the macabre Edgar Allan Poe's The Telltale Heart. Many of you may remember that from ninth grade English classes, and I believe she is the madman.
True. Nervous. Dreadfully nervous I was and am, but how can you say that I am mad? This disease has not dulled my senses, but sharpened them. I have heard all things in heaven and on the earth. I've heard many things in hell. How then can you say that I am mad? Listen, listen! To how carefully, how sanely I can tell you this entire tale. Now, it is impossible to say how the idea was first conceived, but once it was, it haunted me day and night. Object? There was none. Passion? There was none. I loved the old man. He had never wronged me. I had no desires for his gold. I think it was his eye. Yes! It was this. He had the eye of a vulture, a hideous pale blue with a film over it, and every time that it fell upon me, my blood ran cold. So I made up my mind, kill the old man, and thus rid myself of the eye forever. Now, this is the point. You think me mad, but madmen know nothing. Oh, but you should have seen me. You should have seen how wisely, how cautiously I proceeded. I was never kinder to the old man than in the entire week before I killed him. Would a madman been so wise as this? For 7 long nights, I found it impossible to do the work because I always found the vulture eye to be closed. And it was never the old man that vexed me, but rather his hideous, horrible, evil eye. But on the 8th night, I was more cautious than usual in my task. Never before had I felt the extent of my own powers. To think there I was, opening the door little by little, and he had no dreams of my secret plans. I opened the lantern so cautiously, so carefully, you cannot imagine how carefully, until a single thin ray of light, like the bright fire, shot out and fell full upon the vulture eye. It was open, wide open, and I grew furious as I gazed upon it. Then there came to my ears a low, dull, quick sound, like the sound of a watch wrapped in cotton. This was the beating of the old man's heart. It only increased my fury. The old man's hour had come. I dropped the lantern. I leapt into the room. The old man shrieked once, and only once. The deed was done. The old man was dead, and his eye would trouble me no more. You still think me mad? Well, whenever I tell you how I got rid of the body, first I dismembered the corpse. Then I took up 3 floorboards, and I placed all of the pieces underneath. Then I replaced the floorboards so neatly, so carefully, so cunningly, that no eye, no human eye, could have told that there was anything wrong. When I was done, there came a knocking at the door. I went down, and I opened it with a light heart, for what did I have to fear? 3 police officers entered. There had been a shriek heard in the middle of the night, and they were sent to make sure that everything was okay. I smiled, and I welcomed them in, for what did I have to fear now? I showed them all over the house, and I led them to the old man's chambers, where I showed them his treasures secure and undisturbed. I even brought chairs into the room, so that way they could sit and rest themselves. Well, I myself, in my wild audacity of my perfect triumph, placed my own seat upon the very spot where the corpse of the victim lay beneath. We sat and we chatted for a while, but before long I wanted them gone, for this pounding in my head was just so loud. But with horror, I realized that the pounding was not within my head. The pounding was not within my head. I talked in a louder voice. I paced the floor to and fro, trying to cover up the sound, but the sound just got louder, louder, louder. Oh God, what can I do? I foamed, I raved, I swore, I banged my chair against the floorboards, but the sounds just kept getting louder, louder, louder. Oh God, anything was better than this agony. I can almost hear it now. Again, louder, louder, louder. Villains, stop pretending. I did it. I confessed. Tear up the floorboards here. Tear them here. Please, please. Just stop the beating of his hideous heart. Thank you.
It always amazes me that our students can memorize so many lines when their hands are already full with the history and math and science and all those other things. So that is our EJCHS instructional highlight for this evening. And I think we have a phenomenal fine arts department and phenomenal kids in the department. I believe the next thing on the agenda is Rotary students, which shall we just lap right into that? Okay, wonderful. Then if I could get Emily Crow to come join me. She is EJCHS High School's Rotary student of the month. Yes.
We switched to a 3, so the teachers can hear while they will write.
Okay. So you want Emily to have a seat and then teachers can be back. Sorry, Emily, we'll get you back this minute.
Good evening. Georgia's Teacher of the Year program annually spotlights the teaching profession and recognizes outstanding public school teachers at the local and state levels. And tonight, we have 10 outstanding educators to recognize here in Jackson County. So, can I call your name if you will come on up? And we will have certificates that your principals will come up and present to you, and then we'll walk around and show our board would like to shake your hand and congratulate you. Our first teacher of the year is from East Jackson Elementary School, Ms. Abby Potts, kindergarten teacher. Was a product of Jackson County Schools and attended North Georgia College and State University, where she received a degree in early childhood education and special education. She has taught in special education for 5 years in both adaptive curriculum and resource settings. She currently teaches kindergarten at East Jackson Elementary School. Prior to East Jackson, Ms. Potts taught at Benton Elementary. Her colleagues share that she is kind, encouraging, and willing to help other teachers. She also has her students in mind and spends time planning lessons to meet all her students' needs. Her philosophy is that all students can be successful when we meet their needs and believe in them. One cool fact about Ms. Potts is that Ms. Hallie was her kindergarten teacher. This is Ms. Abby Potts. Next teacher of the year is Ms. Casey Bray from Young Springs Elementary School. Ms. Bray teaches fourth grade, and she teaches reading, ELA, and science. The 2018-19 school year marks Ms. Bray's 5th year of her teaching career and her 4th year as a fourth grade teacher at Young Springs. Her first year teaching was completed as a third grade teacher at Statham Elementary. Ms. Bray has a Bachelor's of Science in Early Childhood Education from the University of North Georgia, a Master's degree in Early Childhood Education from Piedmont College, and is currently pursuing her Specialist degree in Curriculum and Instruction from Piedmont. In addition, she also has a reading, ESOL, and gifted endorsement. Casey's collaborative style includes integrating innovative techniques into her classroom in all content areas. In fact, she was one of the first one-to-one private grant winners for Jackson County School System. Through this grant, all of her students have the opportunity to have their own personal Chromebook that allows them to participate in remarkable learning experiences while instantly connecting them to the world around. In addition, Casey has served as a mentor for new teachers, led various professional learning events for her school and district, participated as a community conversation leader, and is a part of many committees at her school and community. Authentic, enthusiastic, diligent, organized, caring, leader, innovative, and integrity are just a few qualities Casey displays in and out of the classroom. Passion is deeply nestled in each of these qualities when providing overall class learning experience. Ms. Casey Gray. Our next teacher of the year is Ms. Julie Herrick from Maysville Elementary School. Julie believes that God's purpose for her is to be a teacher. She also believes that God has filled her with a passion to be a teacher that makes a difference in the lives of those around her. She feels tremendously blessed to have spent 27 years in the classroom sharing her passion with others. Ms. Herrick strives to build a positive relationship with everyone that walks in her door. Her students believe that they are accepted, valued, and loved. Julie wants every child to know that we cannot get through a single day without having an impact on someone around us. She models for students that creating a positive impact at school and at home can be a difference maker in the lives of those we come into contact with. Everything we do matters, and Ms. Herrick wants her first graders to recognize the importance of each decision they make. Ms. Herrick's students learn about the power of yet and how they can use this growth mindset to change their learning. She wants every child to understand that they will learn some things easily and other things will seem hard. If students approach difficult tasks with the power of yet mindset, they will keep telling themselves, I can't do it yet, but my goal is to work hard and make it happen. With practice and encouragement, I've got this. Ms. Herrick believes that this is a vital, important impact that helps her students reach their dreams now and in the future. Congratulations, Ms. Herrick. Next we have from North Jackson Elementary School, Ms. Casey Sheridan, gifted 3-5 STEM coach. Recognizes the potential in every child. She is wholeheartedly committed to her school community of students, teachers, and parents. Ms. Sheridan always has three goals in mind: to build strong connections with every student in her classroom, ensure that students understand the relevancy in what they are learning, and create an environment that builds wonder, excitement, and fun into all subject areas. Ms. Sheridan holds a master's degree from Piedmont University and a bachelor's degree from Brown University. She taught fourth grade at North Jackson Elementary for 3 years and made the decision to stay home after her triplets were born. Wouldn't you? She returned to North Jackson in 2015, teaching fifth grade for 2 years and third grade for 1 year. Ms. Sheridan is now one step closer to her dream of becoming Ms. Frizzle from the Magic School Bus in her current position of 3rd-5th STEM teacher and 2nd-5th gifted resource teacher. She is part of the team that launched the Performing Panthers' first drama club season last year, helping put together a full-scale production of Lion King Kids, and the second season is already underway, working on a production of The Jungle Book, which I think is coming up here very shortly. She has also started the robotics club this year at North Jackson Elementary and is her school's Science Olympiad team leader. Ms. Sheridan serves on the leadership team at her school and is involved in a number of professional learning communities. And I might add, was one of our three finalists for System Teacher of the Year. Congratulations, Ms. Sheridan. is Ms. Cindy Lee from South Jackson Elementary School, first grade. Cindy Lee has taught, forget this, 34 years in Jackson County. University of Georgia. She transferred to South Jackson in 1993 and has been a member of that faculty since. Cindy grew up in Jackson County and attended South Jackson as a student in elementary school. She completed her Master's of Education with a focus on elementary reading and literacy in 2006 through Walden University and has served many years on the South Jackson leadership team. She's also served on many county-level curriculum committees during her career. Cindy has taught kindergarten through third grade. She works hard to instill a love of learning with her students. She believes that reading opens many doors to children and enjoys helping students learn the foundational skills that help them to become lifelong learners and readers. She also believes that all children have the right to the best education in the least restrictive environment. She enjoys teaching an inclusion class, which is composed of regular and special education students learning in the same classroom, with accommodations as needed for each student to be successful. Cindy has three children, all of whom attended or graduated from Jackson County Schools. When she is not working on something for her classroom, she enjoys reading and searching for books to add to her classroom or personal library, as well as camping, planting, and growing flowers, and visiting the beach with her family. And Ms. Lee was also one of our three finalists for System Teacher of the Year. Congratulations. And our final Elementary School Teacher of the Year is Ms. Courtney Phillips from West Jackson Elementary School, fifth grade teacher. As a child, Courtney Phillips struggled through school. It was those struggles that sparked her passion for teaching. She believes that every child has the potential to learn in his or her own way. Ms. Phillips states, "A remarkable teacher is one who tries to reach every student every day. We don't know where the students we teach come from or where they will be going after they leave us. While they are with us for those 7 hours each day, it is our responsibility to love each and every one of them. That is what fuels my passion for teaching, the love we must show each child." Courtney received her bachelor's in middle grade education from the University of Georgia. She earned her master's in elementary education from Piedmont College. Ms. Phillips says she's very blessed to work in the Jackson County school system with the most amazing students every day. Congratulations. Next, we have Ms. Heather Wilbates, East Jackson Middle School, 6th grade math and STEAM. Ms. Heather Wilbates is a 6th grade teacher and a math department chair at East Jackson Middle School. She's been teaching for 10 years, 5 of which have been in Jackson County. Although Ms. Wilbates primarily teaches math, she integrates social studies, science, and language arts into her curriculum. She helped establish and create the Odyssey STEAM team at East Jackson Middle, where she strives to make her students active participants in the classroom. Ms. Wilbanks' teaching philosophy is to create a classroom that is an open stage for students, is relaxing and welcoming, and is a place where students want to learn. She states, "I want students to come to my class and then beg to stay." Ms. Wilbanks graduated with her specialist degree in curriculum and instruction in December. Congratulations, Ms. Wilbanks. And our other middle school teacher of the year is Ms. Sally Ann Short from West Jackson Middle School, 6th grade science. driven to prepare her students for the future by fostering creative problem-solving skills. She's a 24-year veteran who holds both a master's degree and bachelor's degree from the University of West Georgia. Ms. Short models being an enthusiastic lifelong learner that values the development of soft skills such as work ethic, perseverance, and communication. She states, "Educating our youth is one of the most rewarding and challenging aspirations. In my classroom, I aim to prepare students for the future by improving their people skills. Students desperately need the support of compassionate adults, and I model being a lifelong learner in and out of the classroom. While teaching for sixth graders science, she incorporates all subject areas into her lessons to build connections in order to solve real-world problems. Her warm classroom environment offers compassion, belonging, and engaging work. Sally Ann has served in various leadership positions over the years, and she believes that building positive relationships with students is her most important purpose. Congratulations, Ms. Short." Next, we have Mr. Andy Briscoe from East Jackson High School, geometry and pre-calculus teacher. Andy Briscoe is a math teacher at East Jackson Comprehensive High School. This is his 8th year teaching, and the past 4 years have been at East Jackson. He was previously at Line of Arrow High School. Over his 8 years, he has taught algebra, geometry, algebra 2, and pre-calculus. That's pretty much the whole range of classes. He coached baseball for his first 5 years of teaching and girls basketball for his first 2 years. He's currently the lead geometry teacher at East Jackson Comprehensive High School, where their geometry students reported the highest growth rate on their end-of-course test in the state of Georgia for the 2016-17 school year. Andy graduated from the University of Georgia in 2011, majoring in math education and minoring in consumer economics. He has recently finished a master's degree in school library media at the University of West Georgia and will be graduating in December from the University of West Georgia with a specialist in education. Andy has been married to his wife, Laura, for 5 years and they currently live in Watkinsville. Congratulations, Mr. Briscoe. And last, but certainly not least, is Dr. Shannon Lawrence from Jackson County High School, who is an agriculture teacher and also our system teacher of the year. So Dr. Lawrence will receive a plaque for the school teacher of the year, one for system teacher of the year, and he also has a certificate for being one of the state, from the state of Georgia. So one might be surprised that beyond the strong Southern dialect and old-fashioned values of Dr. Shannon Lawrence is the principal framework of a passionate educator. Shannon Lawrence obtained his BSA and Master's in Agricultural Education and Leadership from UGA before starting his career teaching at West Jackson Middle in 2004. He was named Jackson County Teacher of the Year in 2008, West Jackson County High School. Dr. Lawrence obtained his PhD in Agricultural Education at Texas A&M University in 2012, with his research focusing on the retention of induction teachers. He has designed and instructed courses at Texas A&M, Clemson University, and Emmanuel College. He has been at Jackson County High School in his current teaching role since 2015. Dr. Lawrence strives to build rigor in his students while reinforcing the need for solid character traits in future career placement. He has worked with the Kubota Corporation in efforts to teach industry-relevant practices in his classroom. He's also found engaging students in hands-on application in mechanics and science. In a world inundated with technological connectivity, Dr. Lawrence attempts to instill work ethic, critical thinking, and time management with his students, while stressing their need to positively interact in team and leadership roles. Dr. Lawrence has consistently guided students to success on the state and national level in FFA. He considers his role as teachers and future educators one of his most important. It is no surprise that many of his students have gone on to become teachers in agricultural education with his encouragement. And I don't know how he does it all, because he's also an amazing father to four children. Congratulations, Dr. Lawrence. So again, congratulations to all of our teachers of the year.
Well, we'd just like to also say congratulations to all of our teachers. We're so blessed in Jackson County to have so many dedicated and wonderful educators. And so we congratulate each one of these folks and appreciate them so very much for all they do for all of our kids.
Thank you, Ms. Weaver, and the board, and a very special thank you to the Teachers of the Year and your families for being here. We know that for some of the, well, actually all of these folks, to achieve at the levels they've achieved at, they take time away from you. It is a very demanding job, and they make tremendous investment in our shared students here in Jackson County. So it's exceptionally humbling to watch these folks work and know how much they bring to our community. I'm very, very grateful and very, very proud to be a part of working alongside these folks. Ms. Palmer, I want to apologize. We flipped it on the agenda. We didn't make that real clear. So let's continue our board celebration this evening with the Rotary Student Recognition and East Jackson High School. And let's give Ms. Crow a chance to come back up here.
You know, if you will join me and Mr. Terry Miller, if you come along as well. Ellen Crow is East Jackson High School Rotary Student of the Month for the month of January.
And her mom, Julie Crow, is in the audience. Dad, Russell, couldn't be with us tonight. Julie and Russell are wonderful East Jackson High School supporters. And they have sent us two wonderful children. Emily is the second of those. Allison was the older daughter. And I can't believe that next year we're not going to have a Crow in the building with us. That's very sad to me. But we do want to celebrate Emily tonight. In regards to the courses that she is taking, she is going to leave high school with multiple college credits under her belt. She's taken several dual enrollment classes, including algebra, psychology, pre-cal. I think she had Mr. Briscoe, is that right, earlier in her career, yeah. English 1102, she skipped 1101 because she scored high enough on her AP exam to do that. She's also taken economics, multiple band courses, Spanish 2, and allied health and medicine, which is the third course in the healthcare science pathway. She's involved in a number of activities, particularly with the band. She is our marching drum major. She has lettered in band all 4 years. She's a member of Beta Club. She is the president of the National English Honor Society. She is active in sports as well. She has lettered in soccer for 4 years and is co-captain of the varsity soccer team. In regards to honors and awards, she has been the Kiwanis Student of the Month. She is a Georgia Certificate of Merit Scholar. She has been nominated for the Governor's Honors Program in Mathematics, and she has been an academic letterman for 3 years. She's also involved in community service work, playing the saxophone at Talmo Baptist Church, and volunteering at Good News at Noon Homeless Shelter. And so that's a little bit about Miss Emily, who again is a wonderful East Jackson High School student, and she's going to share a little bit about why she chose Mr. Terry Miller as her most influential teacher.
Good evening. Thank you for being here tonight. It's a huge honor to be the Rotary Student of the Month. When they asked me to pick a teacher that has influenced me a lot to honor tonight, the decision was hard and easy all at the same time. Difficult in that I've had many wonderful teachers throughout the years, but easy because one has stood out amongst the rest, and that would be Mr. Miller. I walked into his AP Literature class last year thinking I knew just about everything about writing, but it turns out I did not. Found that out very quickly. Mr. Miller has challenged me to get out of my comfort zone both in the classroom and out. In his class, we read from genres that I typically avoid and wrote in ways that I wasn't completely comfortable with. While that has helped me explore new perspectives in literature, Mr. Miller's teaching style has also taught me to be aware of the perspectives of people around me. Through class discussions ranging from politics to the reasons humans act the way they do, Mr. Miller has taught me to value diversity and to push myself to think outside of the box, even when I didn't want to. These are lessons that I will carry with me throughout my life. So thank you.
Do you want to share with them what you plan to do beyond high school?
Sure, I will. After graduation, I plan to attend Georgia College and State University in Milledgeville to major in nursing and minor in creative arts therapies. I'm hoping to pursue a career as a NICU nurse. And throughout college, I also plan on becoming a Young Life leader and continuing to play saxophone in an ensemble on campus. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Pete Jones, and I'm the principal at Jackson County High School, and it is my honor and privilege to introduce to you tonight the Rotary Student of the Month from our school, and her name is Anastasia Pomianowska. So if you'll come on up here, Anastasia. And her Rotary most influential teacher was Miss Heather Hamrick, and so she's on her way up. And if y'all could kind of step over here, so you're in the big spotlight. So Anastasia is one of those students who I truly admire for finding balance. I talk a lot about finding balance in one's life, and I've recently written a lot about it as well. The reason why I say that is because she's challenged herself academically, but as you'll see as I talk about her classes, she's also found diversity in the types of things that she's studied. She is a three-period work-based learning student this year, for example. We'll talk about that in just a second. She's also getting ready to complete a pathway in audio, video, tech, and film. She's in the third level class there. And then she gets into the meat of her schedule when she's taking AP Calculus BC, Physics, and AP US Government and Politics. So she finishes off with an interesting load there. But again, you can see there that she's going to complete a pathway, she's getting real-world experience in work-based learning, and also challenging herself at the highest level in some of the most difficult AP courses that are offered in our country. She is also very active in our school. She's a member of the National Honor Society, the Beta Club, the French Honor Society, the National Honor Society for High School Scholars. She is a leader at children's Bible camps in Ukraine, and she is also, as I mentioned earlier, she's an intern in the residential marketing department at Jackson EMC. So she is getting a lot of diverse experiences, not only at our school, but beyond the walls of our school. She's also won several awards, including the UGA Merit Award. She's in the top 10% of her class and has been recognized in many of her individual subjects for her excellence in academics. And she was also the first student in school history to earn the seal of biliteracy, in this case in Russian, which recently became an option in Georgia, and she's the first. So congratulations to her. I'm going to let her take the stand here and talk a little bit about what she plans to do after high school. And why Ms. Hamrick was her most influential teacher. So come on up here, Anastasia.
Good evening. I feel very blessed and honored to be the Student Rotary of the Month person. My being here today, I think I could also partially owe to my teachers who have supported me along the way. Every single one of them has really played a part in who I am and my education. But I chose Ms. Hamrick to be my most influential teacher. I first met her in ninth grade when she taught me honors biology, but I don't think I really came to adore her until 10th and 11th grade, which happened to be the hardest years for me in high school because I had a tough course load, which required a lot of effort, time, and sleepless nights. I should probably mention that I spend every single lunch period of my high school career in Ms. Hamrick's classroom. Her classroom is like my home, my little safe place. I like to go there because it's quiet and I can think. And sometimes when I was having a bad day or I was overwhelmed or frustrated, I'd come into her classroom. I didn't even need to say anything. She'd just look at me and say, "You look a little stressed." And I'd say, "Yeah," to which she would reply, "Anastasia, you can do this. I believe in you." And then she'd go on to sing, "I Believe I Can Fly." So even now, sometimes when I'm frustrated, I can hear her voice in my head singing, "I Believe I Can Fly." I personally think that one of the best things a teacher can do for a student is believe in them, and that's what Ms. Hamrick has done for me through my 4 years of high school. So thank you, Ms. Hamrick. There needs to be more of you in this world. After high school, I've applied to a few colleges. I'm not exactly sure which one I'm going to. I've been accepted to Barry and Mercer, but I'm planning on doing a pre-med program with a major in either neuroscience or biology, and then continue on to medical school if God wills. Thank you.
I'm sure she will go far, and thank you so much, Ms. Hamrick, for embracing not only Anastasia, but many students. And I also wanted to thank Anastasia's parents, Yuri and Lilia, for raising such a fine young lady. So thank you so much.
We just hope you'll come back and see us. We want you to come back to Jackson County because you clearly have a lot of gifts to bring. So thank you all. Dr. Blankenship, I believe this is our mic we're going to share, so I'll bring it to you. And we are excited to recognize our Excellence in Service Award winners.
Thank you, Dr. Howard. Those are two amazing students. I got a little choked up listening to them and just how grateful they are for what their teachers have done for them. So we have two outstanding honorees tonight for our Excellence in Service Awards. And the first is Ms. Mandy Byers, who is a volunteer and parent in our school system. So Ms. Byers, if you will come on up. Ms. Byers' nominator chose to remain anonymous, but here is what they had to say. You can just stand over here in the wall. Mandy Byers has been an amazing volunteer for the East Side for several years, and we would like to nominate her for several reasons. Most importantly, she exemplifies true professionalism and integrity in everything she does and works countless hours to make sure each event is successful. She's the first person we think of when we have a special event to coordinate. She always does it to the highest standard, usually either free or under budget. In recent years, we have been able to work more closely with her at East Jackson High School and have been the beneficiary of her great talents and resources. Her contributions have helped us with many events. For example, she was helpful in coordinating vendors and donations for the first ever East Side Community Tailgate. We were able to do the entire event on donations. She has worked countless hours making and delivering food for cheerleaders, donating materials for bows and shirts. Most recently, she coordinated the accommodations for our chorus trip to Hawaii and oversaw the entire budget for this trip. She also donated countless hours to help us make our governor's visit successful by overseeing the refreshments and decorations. She is a small business owner, and her knowledge of our students and community, as well as her connections to other business owners, has been such a valuable resource to us. We not only consider her a partner in Ed, but a true supporter and someone who loves our Eastside community. So congratulations, Carrie.
Thank you.
Our next recipient is also very deserving, and their nominator wished to remain anonymous as well. But we have Ms. Sandra Brown from Jackson County High School. Ms. Brown, just make your way on down here and come stand in the light. Mrs. Brown serves our school system as the cafeteria manager at Jackson County Comprehensive High School. There are days when I arrive to school before 6 a.m. and her car is already parked outside of her office. Ms. Brown performs her duties every day in a very professional manner, and she, along with her staff, is always courteous to students and teachers. Her commitment and love for what she does is evident in the way she performs her job. Her inviting personality and friendly smile, along with her professionalism on the job, improves the overall climate of our school. Data shows that meeting students' nutritional needs positively affects their academic performance. Ms. Brown plans and prepares meals that provide our students with the nutritional resources they need to succeed in the classroom. Bottom line, students and teachers enjoy her food. With a servant's heart, she is always willing to lend a helping hand at any time to aid in the success of our students. I'm writing this letter of recommendation because I have witnessed the impact Ms. Brown has made to help our students succeed. Congratulations, Ms. Brown.
Thank you, Ms. Byers and Ms. Brown. Again, these are just amazing examples of what a fortunate community we are a part of, to be a part of this community, some amazing people. So thank you very much to all of you. The last superintendent's comment I have there is just a reminder that our board will host a new high school groundbreaking ceremony on January 31st. That's over off Skelton Road. We're excited to see the facility that we're in here today being used, and we look forward to having a facility for the West Jackson community coming online here in just a couple of years. So that's just a reminder, and that is all of the superintendent's comments I have at this time.
All right, thank you. And now, do you have any comments about before we have our
I'll be happy to.
Agenda.
I will be glad to. Yes, thank you. I do want to just, since we do have some board members that are new to us, clarify our consent agenda items. Of course, the first is the minutes from our work session on Thursday. And then we are recommending to proceed with the resource for substitutes that you heard about on Thursday. We look forward to that. The next one is a shared services MOU with Northeast Georgia RESA, the Regional Educational Services Agency, and we partner with 12 other, there are 13 school districts in Northeast Georgia, and they provide services that individual school systems really can't provide independently. For example, things like speech language and shared services for deaf and hard of hearing students, and physical therapy, occupational therapy. So these are staff members that are actually employed by Northeast Georgia RESA that serve all 13 school districts, and we make a contribution to support that service. And so they are a treasured partner in the work. We would not be able to do the work that we do without them. So this is an annual memorandum of understanding that we sign in agreement with them. Of course, we talked about Dr. Blankenship is working diligently to upgrade and revise our job descriptions, and so you have a couple of those there for you, and of course our continued personnel actions that you
that you review each month. We do have some exciting retirements, excited for those folks, but it's a little sad. We're losing, as always, some treasured assets to the Jackson County school system, but we are proud for them. So those are all the comments, unless there are any questions from the board.
Are there any questions before we vote? All right, well, using consent agenda for items 1 through 7, do I have a motion that we approve?
So moved.
Okay, and second?
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
All right, and do I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Okay, and second?
Second.
All right. Everybody in the good. In favor, and in favor. Okay, all right. Very good. Thank you for being with us tonight, and congratulations to all the outstanding educators and young people. We appreciate you all. Good night.
Thank you.